Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us. MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the Houston Astros taking on the Seattle Mariners. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Okay, all set to go. Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve. The pitch. Next offering misses down and away. The 2-1. On the ground to short. Crawford picks it up. On the run, throw to first. They get him, but it was pretty close. Now Michael Brantley steps in. One down, base is empty. And that one wrapped foul. And now it's 1-2. And downstairs. No score, just getting started, top of the first. On the ground, out to short. Crawford throws to first in time, and they get Brantley for the out. Two outs, base is empty. Alex Bregman getting ready to hit. The wind and the pitch comes up empty. That's strike two. Ground ball left side, whips it to first, and they get Bregman for the out. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. We go to the bottom of the first, and now for Seattle, Adam Frazier. Line drive, caught! And up next for Seattle, Ty France.
The first baseman, Tom France.
The pitch. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. And down on strikes. Two away. Here's Jesse Winker.
The designated hitter.
A wide to kick the pitch.
Winker.
Good eye right there.
We got two balls, one strike.
Now a slow roller to second. Altuve collects it. Tosses to first. And Winker is set down. And that'll do it. New inning getting started. Here's Yordan Alvarez. The 1-1. Swing and a miss. Ray, he has a reputation. I don't know, maybe a knack for working himself out of tough situations that he finds himself in. You know, you like that in a relief pitcher, but when you have it for a starting pitcher, a guy that can get out of a tight spot, that is pretty valuable.
And you won't see the skipper rush to get somebody up in the bullpen as soon as he starts to see some signs of trouble. This guy's earned.
Now this ball is well hit. This one's got a chance. Bangs off the wall. And that's a leadoff double.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. A well-deserved double on a great swing. Got everything going on time. He stayed balanced and he squared it up about as well as you could possibly ask.
Yuli Gurriel comes up to hit. How much of the ability to do that in a tight spot is the mental approach?
I think it's very much being able to have a laser-like focus, slow everything down, stay right in that moment, pitch-to-pitch execution, and focusing on that catcher's mitt.
Flashes the leather on the running catch. And there's one away. Here's Kyle Tucker. Second inning here, no score. Ground ball right side, and foul ball. The 1-2 off the outside edge, and now the count is 2-2. Hard hit, left field, base hit. They won't risk the send. Runners at the corners now with one away.
Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it. Runner in scoring position now, and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ball game.
Now here is Chaz McCormick on the ground right side. Base hit, and a run comes in.
Back-to-back base hits. Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Now, Jeremy Pena, and that's ball four.
Now, that sets up a really big at-bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
One down. Martin Maldonado up to hit. That one out to right. Haniger has a beat on it. Squeezes it. Here comes the runner from third. The tag, and that's out number three. Inning over. Back in Seattle, bottom of the inning, and here's the veteran outfielder, Mitch Haniger. And a pitch. That misses the zone, and the count's full. Right-hander kicks, deals. On the ground, Bregman. Over to first, and quickly one away in the second. Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. And Chris, probably no other player better represents present-day baseball than this guy. A lot of power, a lot of strikeouts, and some walks. Slow roller to first. Gurriel picks it up. A flip to the pitcher covering. Two up, two down. Two outs, base is empty. And stepping in for the Mariners, J.P. Crawford. And here it comes. That one to first. Gurriel handles. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Set for the start of the inning. Jose Altuve up to hit here. Here comes a pitch. And down on strikes he goes. And one gone. Here's Michael Brantley. 0 for 1 so far. And a pitch. Stays alive. Kicks and deals. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The next offering misses. 2-2. Good eye in that spot.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Ninth pitch of the at-bat due next. Next pitch has popped up. He's got it, and there's two down. Now the third baseman, Alex Bregman. Grounded out his first time up. And he deals. And that one fouled off. And misses inside. Next one in the dirt. The pitch. And he gets Bregman. And the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. This is Kyle Lewis. Two and one now. Lined into left center, base hit. So a man on base to start the inning.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Here's Jared Kelnick. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. One strike. Righty delivers. And there's a ball.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base. Try to stay out of a double play here.
There's a swing and a drive. Way back. And that one's gone. A shot to the opposite field. And they jump out front. It's 2-1. Now it's John Murphy. Strike two.
It can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Hit on the ground to the right side. Gurriel sends it to first. One away. That ground ball may have him back on track after the home run. And here is Adam Frazier. He's 0-for-1. And a pitch. On the ground to the left. In time to Gurriel. Frazier retired.
Good fade and sinking action of that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over.
Ty France up next for the Mariners. Yeah, the 2-1 hammered but foul. And a pitch. That misses the zone. And that's ball three. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. That is the inning. On to the fourth. Now it's Yordan Alvarez.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Swing and a miss, struck him out, and now one away. Now it's Yuli Gurriel. 0-for-1 with a flyout. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. So next up for Houston, Kyle Tucker, a guy who makes an impact not just at the plate but also in the field. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Swing and a miss. 1-2.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
2-2 down. And it's fouled away. Two down, nobody on. And there's ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
So two down. Chaz McCormick up next for the Astros. The next pitch misses. Ball two. And now the count filled up 3-2.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Welcome back. Ready to go. Bottom four. In now is the Mariners DH, Jesse Winker. And a 1-1.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
That one in for a strike, 2-2.
And this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Bounce to the left side. Slings it across. One up, one down.
Well, a well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break on that one.
Now batting Mitch Haniger. First time up, he grounded to third. Here's a 1-1. This one chopped on the ground, but foul. 1-2 now. Up the middle. in plenty of time to first, and they take care of Haniger for the out. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. He is very much your typical power hitter. I'd say he falls into the three true outcomes category.
Well, we've seen more and more of that lately. The ability to drive the ball to slog is getting heavily favored over any discipline or strike.
Oh, that's a strikeout, and that'll do it for the inning. Ready now for the fifth inning. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Jeremy Peña. Now all even up. Line drive. Leaping. Can't haul it in. Throws to second, but he's in there easily.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there.
Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of his stick.
And now, Martin Maldonado. Next offering is down low. And a count 2-1. So the tying run at second. Fouls one off. 2-2. And now it's filled up.
You know, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around. Not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point. Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
Squirts away a little bit. Tag, save! He's into third on the wild pitch. On the ground, a short could be two. Over to second for one. They get the out, but the run scores on the twin killing. And Michael Brantley is going to come up to hit. In the air, right field. Haniger under it. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. And welcome back. We head to the bottom of the fifth. At the plate, J.P. Crawford. And the right-hander deals. And that one is lifted in the air. Brings it in, and there's one down.
Well, on the mound, very efficient. Able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
And now for Seattle, Kyle Lewis. And he's already singled in this game. Bounce to third. And it finds its way through for a hit. So a man aboard now with one away. So up next, Jared Kelnick. Urquidy with a move to first. And he's back safely. Next pitch just misses. Two balls, two strikes. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And there are two down. So here's Murphy now. That one not close. And that's ball three. There's a strike.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Swing and a miss, and that is that. Back here at the ballpark, digging in, Alex Bregman. K kicks and fires. Check swing. He held up. And a count 2-1. On the ground, right side. France gets it to first. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
Good slider inside right there. Batter fighting to get there. Just rolled over it. Got the ground ball.
The wind of the pitch. That one missed. Here's a 2-1. Hammer, base hit.
Well, patience and discipline paid off right there as he got into an advantage count. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Here's Gurriel. Check swing, but he went too far. And a count 1-2. Wouldn't chase that time. Alvarez leads off first with one away. Next one misses. 3-2 now. The pitch. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. And now the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. Here's a 1-1. And now 2-1 after that missed inside. And a swing and a miss. Picks up strikeout number 7. Back at T-Mobile Park, here's Adam Frazier. To the right side, Altuve handles it, fires over to first. Frazier retired. Now the number 2 hitter, Ty France.
The first baseman, Todd Fritz.
Next offering is foul back. Next one misses. The count now 2-2. He swings and fouls one off. 2-2 now. Stays alive. Here's the 2-2. Good eye right there. And the righty deals. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
One gone, runner at first. Jesse Winker, the next to hit at the belt and fires. In the air, right center field. This is demolished. Way back and gone. He'll circle the bases. Just like that, they move in front. It's 4-2.
What I love about this swing is he stayed tall, allowed his hands to go directly to the baseball, letting that bat head get down through the ball to create backspin and hit it out of the ballpark. Really nice job.
Astros go to the pen, and here comes Phil Maton. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
So one out, nobody on. Mitch Haniger up next for the Mariners. Next offering is foul back. That hits the dirt. Now 2-2. The pitch. Swing and a ball popped up. Pena under it. And there's two away. Next to hit, Eugenio Suarez.
The third baseman, Eugenio Suarez.
Right-handed reliever. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
Oh, that's that slurve right there. He threw it extremely well. And talk about just a ton of breaks. So tough to get that barrel to.
That one the other way. Pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And that is the third out of the inning. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Andres Munoz. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise. Top of inning number seven, and stepping in for the Astros, Chaz McCormick. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one is absolutely belted way back there. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Got him. Two down. Two outs. Base is empty. Martin Maldonado up next for the Astros. The pitch. Strike on the inside corner.
Well, now that this is a bullpen game, it's clear that whichever bullpen steps up the most is likely going to come away with the W.
Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. New pitcher now, Blake Taylor. And he'll do his best to keep this close. Back in Seattle, bottom of the seventh, and the batter will be the shortstop, J.P. Crawford. Left-hand batter waits. Fouled off. He was late. The punch out there. Now one away. So digging in, Kyle Lewis. And now the lefty, and he walked him. Jared Kelnick digs in now. And here it comes. And that's outside. Pitch misses, and the count is 3-1.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
And ball four to aboard. And up next for Seattle, Tom Murphy.
It's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Base hit. Lewis rounds third, headed for the plate. The throw's offline. He's safe. And they're up by three.
Big at bat to pad their lead up to three. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Oh, here we go. Pedro Baez.
The human rain delay. He's sped up this year, though.
And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Now it's the second baseman, Adam Frazier. Here comes a pitch. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Righty to the plate. Swing and a ball lifted to center field. McCormick racing over to make the catch. And stepping in for the Mariners, Ty France.
The first baseman, number 23, John France.
On the ground to third, to second, Altuve, and that is the inning. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Diego Castillo trying to protect this lead. Ready to begin the eighth. Here's the Astros leadoff man, Jose Altuve. This one blasted deep to left. Way out of here. Home run. Jose Altuve will touch them all, and they cut into the deficit. It's 5-3. Michael Brantley stands in. On the ground to first, sneaks through, base hit. No outs, runner at first. Here's Alex Bregman. The 2-1. That one drifts inside.
Now these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
3-2 now. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. First out in the top of the eighth. Next is the designated hitter, Yordan Alvarez. Brantley stands at first with one out. Up the middle, Frazier to Crawford for one. Double play, and that'll do it for the inning. Rafael Montero into the game.
Now pitching for the Astros, number 47, Rafael Montero.
Welcome back. And now the DH, Jesse Winker. Swing and a ball popped up, and Winker is set down. And there's one down. Mitch Haniger up next for the Mariners.
Mitch Haniger.
Here's a 1-2. And down on strikes. And there's two down. Eugenio Suarez up next for the Mariners.
Eugenio
Suarez. Two outs. And a big swing and a miss.
For this guy, it's truly a battle when he steps into the box. Only one thing on his mind, seeing that pitch out of the hand and hitting it hard somewhere.
How big a deal is that walk?
I don't think it's a big deal, because if you pitch to the previous hitter with the power he has, he can hit a home run. I think it was a calculated walk. We'll see how it pays off here.
And the right-hander deals. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Left-hand hitter waits. Off the mark there. 2-2.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Two, two now. That one ran inside, almost got him. Good battle here, about to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Swung on, belted. That one back. Pulls it in on the warning track. We're back. back, it's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Paul Sewald.
Number 37, Paul.
And welcome back to the batter now, Yuli Gurriel. Payoff pitch. And a foul ball. Sewald, he's known as a reliever that excels in really tough situations, those high leverage spots. It seems like he's at his best in these situations, and obviously the ability to get the strikeout factors in.
Yeah, there are certain guys that expect to come in and dominate, and they see the challenge, the battle, just a little bit differently. They trust their stuff, and they believe that their stuff is better than that guy standing in the batter's box, what his swing, what his ability is.
That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Now it's the right fielder, Kyle Tucker. And a pitch. In the air, right field. Haniger settles under it. Puts it away for the out. The mental approach is a big factor too, isn't it?
Yeah, Boog, it is. And, you know, for each guy, it can be a little different. Some people consciously work on focusing, slowing things down, breathing techniques. And then there's some players that are just natural, and they just seem to be more composed and less excitable.
Suarez to second. Out. A double play to end it.
Well, you can tell these guys feel great and also relieved to even up the series. There's so much on the line. You've worked so hard to get here. I wouldn't be surprised if we see a game seven in this series.
Here's one final look at the line score from this one, Chris.
It was a close two-run game, and a couple of key moments just really made the difference. Not much separates these two teams.
A 5-3 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.